It is now thought that by the first half of the next century, energy consumption will be up fourfold, and that the amount of CO2 in the atmosphere could have doubled. A slower release of CO2 into the atmosphere might not have mattered. By no means all of the CO2 remains in the air. About half is absorbed by the oceans. But this is a slow and poorly understood process. It was, in fact, the sea's capacity to absorb CO2 that made scientists skeptical that it would ever present a serious problem.
Up until about 1960, the prevailing scientific view was that the oceans could soak up all of the CO2 that might come from the combustion of fossil fuel. But in 1957 and 1958, during the International Geophysical Year, two observatories were set up, one on the side of Mauna Loa at about 11,000 feet and one at the South Pole, and we began to make measurements of atmospheric CO2 there.
Mauna Loa is well situated. Located on Hawaii, in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, it's remote and free from any kind of pollution, ideal for monitoring small background changes in the atmosphere. Regular samples were collected, and it soon became clear that the atmosphere around the Earth did contain increasing levels of CO2. There was a steady rise from, in 1958, 316 parts per million, to, in 1981, 338 per million,